Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today, we're going to be taking a look at some comments from Renee Young's recent interview about her WWE exit and what went wrong, as well as some long-term plans for Roman's huge opponent in the future. Let's start things off with Renee Young. We haven't spoke much about Renee Young since her WWE departure was announced. But Renee has been very active in recent weeks when it comes to interviews. There's new Renee Young interviews coming out every day, and she's talking about so many different topics and issues. So I wanted to go over all these dozens of Renee interviews at once and see what she has to say. Renee was recently a guest on the Sports Media podcast, and she talked about some of her high and low points in WWE, as well as this transitional period she's currently in. Renee had this to say about where she's at right now. Technically, I'm still employed with Fox Sports. I'm no longer with WWE though. It's been really weird, even going back to while I was there and had these days marked on the calendar. The clock was ticking and I was trying to put the finishing touches on my book. It ended up leaking out that I was leaving, so I had all these people reaching out to me and asking questions while I was still trying to do everything that I needed to do. It was a really hectic situation. Now that I'm past all of that, I can just kind of relax and refocus on what I want my next career move to be. Coming from the days of having all my days planned out and whatnot, it's kind of like battling myself on being able to fully relax and take my time. But I'm starting to feel that sense of urgency to make a decision on what my next move is going to be. Renee also talked about her time on Raw commentary and issues with the communication of Vince McMahon while she was on commentary. I definitely felt like I lost steam, but couldn't quite put my fingers on why. I really felt like they were going to give me the keys to the castle and everyone was supportive. But once my run on commentary ended up not being what everyone thought it would, certainly wasn't what I hoped it would be. They just ended up kicking me back to Fox to do my thing, which was fine, but I just felt lost. Everything outside of Raw commentary and hosting a show on Fox just seemed like a step back. I felt like I was spinning my wheels and there was nowhere to go. I was the A person in a broadcast for the majority of my career. And now, all of a sudden, I'm the third voice on a commentary table. Graves and Cole have been calling SmackDown for so long and cover everything wall to wall that by the time an opportunity came up, there wouldn't be much left to say. Another major issue for Renee on commentary was calling her husband's matches. Renee said she was told not to mention her relationship with John on commentary, but they would have Corey Graves ask her strange questions about John Moxley. They made her even more confused on what to say. Renee had this to say about that little situation right there. My head was spinning. I would be told all the time, don't say anything about it. Just call the match as it is and we're not going to mention it. Then the next thing I know, Graves is getting fed lines about wondering what we talk about at the dinner table or what we talk about at home. It was such a weird thing. And when he re-debuted as a heel, I was struggling with saying the right things to put him and his character over. I knew how important it was to him and how much time and effort he put into making that heel run a success. I thought I was going to be the one to trash it and not make it successful. It was a lot of pressure to get it right. The biggest problem I had was not being able to hear Vince in my headset. I was constantly like, wait, what? Or asking him to repeat himself in the little spy cam at the desk. Obviously, when you're out there, you know people are going to be throwing a bunch of stuff at you, but it's really difficult if you can't hear them or understand what they're saying. There's a lack of communication to it. Even when I'd ask for direction on how to be produced, I wouldn't really get it. It goes both ways. As many times I felt overproduced, there was an equal amount of time I really felt that I was hung out to dry. So I found that comment from Renee about her time on Raw commentary to be quite interesting because it provides a lot of context to why she felt so unnatural on commentary. Renee was getting a lot of bad feedback from fans as well for her commentary. Some fans even claiming that she sounded like the robotic commentary from WWE video games. But telling from these comments and really looking back at Renee's time on Raw commentary, I think she would have done an amazing job. It just sounds like they threw so much at her and really overwhelmed her with so many instructions. It sounds like there was a lot of, don't talk about this, say this, don't mention that, sort of thing going on with Renee Young on commentary, and it got to the point where she was just unsure on what to actually say. Like the example that Renee used, on one hand, you're telling her don't talk about your relationship with Jon Moxley, but then at the same time, they're having Corey Graves question her about what her and Jon talk about over dinner at home. That's horrible because you put Renee in such an uncomfortable and strange spot. She's over here thinking, okay, don't talk about my relationship with my husband. Then they ask her a question like that. She wasn't ready or prepared at all to answer that question because she wasn't expecting it. I just think Renee could have done amazing on commentary if it was just more natural and they didn't overwhelm her with so many things. Just reading through her comments, it sounds like a nightmare to be on commentary, calling a match, talking to your colleagues and having people screaming instructions into your ear through your headset. It sounds very overwhelming from an outsider's perspective. Renee is still on her 90-day no-compete clause, so we'll have to wait for that to expire to see where Renee will take her career to next. So we have another interesting update to Roman Reigns and the Universal Championship. If it isn't obvious to you already, Roman Reigns is reportedly set to have a very long reign as Universal Champion, which is great news considering his fresh new feel to his character that I love. So it's going to be interesting to see the feuds Roman gets into and just how he interacts with other superstars. He has this really cocky and sarcastic feel to his character right now that is really entertaining. So I'm really hoping we see more of Roman just interacting with other superstars. Apparently, the long-term plan for Roman Reigns is to have him face The Fiend at next year's WrestleMania. This is another believable storyline because it really makes sense. The Fiend was never pinned for the title and never got a rematch for the title either. Reason being that they want to save that Roman Reigns vs Bray Wyatt feud for WrestleMania 37, which I actually love. I really thought Bray Wyatt would be Roman's first opponent, but it seems like they'll be saving Bray vs Roman for WrestleMania season, which I really don't mind at all. Bray Wyatt has been in the Universal title picture on a consistent basis since last October, so it makes sense to give him a little break from the title scene and bring him back into the scene around WrestleMania season. The story is right there in front of us. Bray Wyatt was never pinned, and he's not going to forget about what Roman did at all. It'll be interesting to see what Bray Wyatt does from now until WrestleMania season, though. There's a lot of rumors about creating a new Wyatt family, possibly linking up with Alexa Bliss, and a lot of other rumors. So there should be a lot of storyline material to keep him busy until WrestleMania 37. But it looks like Roman will be walking through everyone very easily, and his hardest challenge will be The Fiend, Bray Wyatt, down the line around WrestleMania. What are your thoughts on the topics we talked about today? How do you feel about Renee Young's reveals and the possibility of Roman Reigns versus Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania? Leave your comments below. Don't forget to subscribe with all notifications on and leave a like if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys.